What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to another day in my Corvette life. Today, I'm going to be showing you all the steps that I take to prepare the car for the weekend. You know, the weekends are the times for car shows and cruises and all that fun stuff, so want to keep the car in tip-top shape, looking good, so your car looks really good at the shows. So here we go. First thing I do is go to the gas station. You know, generally Corvettes get pretty decent fuel mileage if you're putzing around, but let's be honest, we don't buy these cars to putz around. I can do that in any car, so if you got your foot in it a lot, it sucks up the gas, but hey, it's miles per gallon, right? So something I do about once a month or once every four fill-ups, something like that, is I put some fuel system additives in it. C5s tend to, especially the higher mileage ones, they tend to get some buildup on the fuel sending unit, which ends up causing the fuel gauge to read at empty. So that's a pretty common thing. So if you get some like Tecron or something to put in the fuel tank once a month or once every few thousand miles or whatever, that'll prevent that and save you a lot of money. Another thing to keep in mind if you are putting fuel additives in your car is always put the additives in the tank before you fill up with gas. That way when you put the gas in, it mixes around and it just mixes the fuel consistently throughout the tank. Always make sure you're putting high octane in, at least 91. All right, all filled up. Let's go back to the house. Back home. Now, the next thing I always do is I always check the tire pressure in all four tires, especially these low profile tires. They can be a little, it's a little harder to tell just visually because of the small sidewall that you never know if you might have run over a nail or something last time you put the car away. So always check your tire pressure. If your dash does have the tire pressure gauges in it, even better, but it's always good to check it manually as well. These wheels that I have here are actually C6 Z06 wheels, and they actually don't have the pressure monitor in them, so my gauges don't work, so I always check them manually. If you don't know what pressure your tires should be at, there's a couple of things you can do. If you're running the stock OEM tire size, you can look in the door sill here. There's a sticker that says what size tires they are and the max cold tire pressure, PSI. Since I don't have the stock tire size, I always have to check the sidewall of the tire will always tell you. So if you look on here, it says never exceed 40 PSI. Now remember, that's the max PSI, so I never put the tires up to the full 40 PSI. I usually go about 10% less than what the max is, so 10% less off of 40 would be 36 PSI. So let's go ahead and do it. Another good tip for you guys is always keep a tire gauge in your car, all of your cars, doesn't matter what it is, but these come in really handy. Invest in a little bit of a better one, not the cheap one. These ones that have the pressure release button on the side of them are usually pretty good. They're pretty accurate. Some of the cheaper ones, they're not as accurate.
Or if you're at home and you have your own air compressor, I would invest in one of these. These are really handy. Not only can you put air in your tires with it, but it's also got a built-in tire gauge.
All right, now that the tires are all up to the proper pressures, it's time to wash the car. So as far as what products I use, I'm not too crazy. I use this Meguiar's Gold Classic. Seems to do the job pretty well. I do use a lambskin mitt. This is nice and soft. Doesn't, or shouldn't leave any scratches on your car. But if you do use towels or something, make sure you're using something really soft like a microfiber. You know, anytime you're touching the car, you take a chance of scratching it. So you want to use something as soft as possible. All right, now that the car is all rinsed off, I do use a two bucket system, one for the soap and water and one to rinse. And I do use a brush on the wheels. Obviously, you never want to use a brush on the paint, but for the wheels, it's just fine. All right, so now that the car is all clean and washed off, it's time to dry it. So a lot of you guys may use towels. Again, every time you touch the car, you run the risk of scratching the paint. So what I do and what a lot of people do with, you know, sports cars or even everyday cars, if they want to keep their paint nice, is they use some kind of air system to blow the water off. I've even seen guys use leaf blowers, but they do make some electric air blowers, and I'm actually gonna use my air compressor. Haven't tried that yet, so let's do it. So guys, if you don't believe me, check this out. Back in the garage, got it all dried off. Now the next step is just to, if there's anything left on the car, just go over it lightly with some quick detail, and then it's time to wash the windows. And last but not least, and the absolute most difficult thing to clean on these cars is the inside of the windshield. I've got one of these things. I don't even know what they're called, but this thing is a lifesaver. They're like 10 bucks at AutoZone. Definitely worth the money. It's a lot. Yeah, you need one of these. And just like that, it's all clean. Now I'm sure there's gonna be a ton of comments on this video saying, oh, you're doing it wrong, blah, blah, blah. Guys, there's a million and a half different ways to wash your car. Do your research, find the products that you like, find the methods that you like, and do it the way that you like. I do it the way that I like. It's convenient. I know there are better ways, but quite honestly, I don't have all day. It's getting dark outside. I need to eat dinner, and I gotta finish this video. All right, now to wrap up this video, it's time to give away some t-shirts. In one of last week's videos, I said to comment below if you wanted to enter the giveaway. So it's time to pick those winners.
All right, I will be using this website, YouTube Random Comment Picker. All I did is copy the link of that video into here, and then I'm going to scroll down. So you guys are seeing this in real time. Hit start. And there's winner number one. One bad C3 Corvette. Congratulations, you won one of the Corvette shirts. And for the second t-shirt, here we go. Phil Ravlin.
All right, congratulations to the winners. So I will put my email address down here at the bottom of the screen. If you guys could email me your address, I will get those shirts out to you as quickly as I can. Well, that's gonna do it for today's video. I hope you guys did enjoy it, and hopefully I can do some more giveaways here in the near future. So if you did like today's video, please give me a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, please hit the subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.